Hello, dreamers, and welcome to this episode of Diamond Painting 101, all about how to work with large size canvases. I know we all love working with big canvases, the bigger the better, because they're full of hours of fun, but sometimes we just don't have the space. Take some tips from Nataliya on how to get around this common frustration. Be sure to hit that subscribe button so you don't miss out on any future videos. Let's jump right in.
Nataliya here, and I would love to thank you so much for all your comments, guys. You are amazing. Thank you for your support, and I'm so glad that my videos can help to somebody, even if it's one person. It makes me happy. Okay, so in one of my previous video, I shared with you about size of the canvas, how to pick which size is better, like small canvas versus the larger size of the canvas. So we cover all that, but today we're gonna cover how to work with big canvas. What happens if you, for example, don't have big space in your room, and maybe you limited to work maybe on a kitchen table or somewhere like your computer desk, and you don't have a big craft room. And to be honest, I'm lucky enough to have a big, huge craft table. And guess what? I still work on my computer desk because I love to watch YouTube channel and watch the other YouTubers, their craft, how they drill, and share their stories. So I'm kind of like work together, and we share the same love for diamond painting, and it's good to support the other YouTubers as well. So I'm gonna show you how I work on my little space computer desk with large canvas. And maybe this is something that you really need to know, and you didn't kind of, you just didn't figure out how to work yet. So if you have a big canvas, but you did not figure out yet how to place this on a small little space, let's go, and I'm gonna show you how I work. So let's go.
Okay, so here it is. I wanna show you my little space. That's where magic happens. And I love to drill, and in this moment I'm watching Kaylin, her meditation video. If you guys didn't see that yet, I really highly recommend. It's awesome, it's really relaxing, you will love it, so check this out. But here, as we can see here, my canvas, this one is 40 by 50. That's the canvas I'm working on right now. And as much this table is almost kind of fit, almost perfect, but still part of the canvas is on the top of the computer stand, and this screen is just huge. So not always canvas can be nice and flat, and especially when I was working on a canvas that have like 1.20 meters long, and it was like no way I would fit on this desk. So let me show you how I work if I want to minimize space to the minimum and make sure I have a still comfortable way to drill. So let me set up my camera and I will show you what to do. There is a different way how to approach a different size of the canvas. And in Dreamer Design, we offer for you 30 by 40 centimeters or 40 by 50. So if 40 by 30, it's probably a good canvas for you to start, because you're still gonna see good details, and it's not gonna be pixelated as you would go for 15 centimeters, 15 by 20, stuff like that. So these two sizes is the most common sizes that usually people buying, and it's most affordable as well. So let's say we have much bigger canvas. So what to do and how can you start? I would do roll a little bit. Pretend this canvas you do not start paint yet, and this is all empty, no drills yet, so we're not gonna damage anything. We're just gonna roll, and then I have like this kind of clips that I bought from a dollar store. I would do pinch on one side in here, and then I would do the same thing on the other side. And as you can see, my canvas stay is not rolling. So now I would put this way towards my computer screen, and here I have good amount of space to work on. And maybe somewhere in your drawers you have this kind of clips, like paper clips or documents. This work as well. You see? So either way it will work. Maybe you have those old-fashioned clothesline pins that somewhere in your drawer you already forgot about them. They will work wonderful as well. So you just try and see. So now I can work, I can peel this side of my clear sheet. Okay, and I have place to work. If you're afraid that you can stick to the some parts of the glue, you can put parchment paper on one on the bottom. For example, you already work a little bit in here, you want to still keep protective and clean from dust or pet's fur, you put parchment paper. Just make sure it's not wax paper, because this is big difference between wax paper and parchment paper. So you put here parchment paper, and then you can put your hand, rest your wrist on a protective sheet, and you're not gonna stick, and you're gonna place your diamonds. And then, let's say you already finish half of this canvas, you place your drills in here. What I would do next, I would unroll this side. I would flip the other way and pinch this side, but not too tight. Remember, usually when I roll my finished diamond painting, I always roll this way. But because right now we have protective sheet, if I'm gonna roll that way, it will crinkle up fabric, because the glue hold on the clear sheet. So I was just like slightly would cover this way, pinch again with the pins to keep your canvas steady, and then you can start from the other side, same thing as you did the other way. And then you can meet up in the middle and finish your diamond painting. So if you are a beginner, and I would say start from smaller size, and find this, if this is comfortable for you or not to work with, because maybe you already finished your first diamond painting and that was round drills, and you think, okay, you already done small size of round drills canvas, then you can purchase square drills, big canvas, and you will be good. But let me just remind you guys that this is much different and more difficulty levels than round beads. So maybe you want to start first from 30 by 40 size and see how much you like it, and then you purchase 50 by 40, and that way you will not get too disappointed if this is too hard for you, and a big size canvas will take you a while to finish. So I would say go smaller first till you get used to it. But if you are like stubborn person, you want bigger canvas and that's it, and you know you will do it, go for it, and you will have so much fun. Now, what's the difference between small and bigger canvas? Obviously, you're gonna have a much more fun, right? The more hours you drill, the more fun you will have. Now, let's say you don't have computer desk, but you have this little folded table. So with my techniques, as you see, I pinch, I roll, and it's fit perfectly on this little tiny table. And now you can sit next to your kitty cat and maybe watch TV across your room by sitting comfy on a sofa. And this is the smallest space ever that you can have for your diamond painting, but it's sure comfortable one. You just need an extra chair next to you so you can put your drills on something, or just bring a one color at a time, and you can put your tray like right in here and you work from here. And that's the way you can do also on a little space. As I always say,
go bigger or go home. So if you still didn't figure out what size of the canvas would be perfect for you to start, maybe, and you have to think what you're gonna do with when you finish your diamond painting. Look around your house and see if you have wall free space for your diamond painting. Maybe the painting that you order are not big enough, or maybe not small enough, and maybe you don't have a room in your house where you can place your diamond painting on the wall. So the benefits of small diamond painting, I would say, if you get like really really tiny diamond painting, you can frame it and simply put on your table, even as a decorative piece somewhere on a fireplace. If you buy bigger canvas, let's say 30 by 40, you can frame it and put maybe over your fireplace if you have an empty space up there. It's all about what you want to do with it. Maybe you want to give it to somebody as a gift and you want to be representable and it's nice. So it's always wonderful to receive gift, and smaller size would be faster for you to finish. And as I say, I never count how many hours I work on my diamond painting. But for example, this diamond painting behind me, it has lots of confettis as well, because all those bushes and beautiful flowers then blooming take me a little longer because there's a more change of the color. But I think 4 or 5 days, and the other diamond painting I finish in 2 or 3 days. It is lots of hours per day I work on it, because I do my business from home, so I have more time than the other people. So when you see I'm finished my diamond painting too fast, doesn't mean I work like 1 or 2 hours per day. It's much more than that, and I just love this craft so much that I can't stop drilling. So guys, if this video helped you, please give me thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to this channel, so you can follow up and see my other video. And don't forget to go and check them all from beginning, so you don't miss any tips that I give to you.
Thank you so much for watching. Leave us a comment down below if you take over your entire kitchen or have a small space in the corner of your house dedicated to diamond painting. We'd love to know. Be sure to give this video a thumbs up and hit that notification bell so that you don't miss out on any future videos. Goodbye for now, and remember to paint with passion.